Making moves with Michael. Listen, today we're gonna talk about the one thing that everybody hates, which is pain, baby. Ah. Yeah, pain, motherfucker. We're gonna talk about pain.
Emotional pain.
Get up, your mouth. All right, awesome. So now that you understand what pain is, there's different kinds of pain. There's physical pain, there's mental pain, there's emotional pain, right? There's all kinds of different pains. So today we're going to talk about the 7 reasons why you need to go through pain, why pain is actually good for you. Whether it's an emotional thing where you're breaking up with your wife, your girlfriend, your cousin, hopefully not your wife, right? But there is divorces out there, a lot of them. If you're having problems with your children, okay, having problems with your coworkers. Maybe you're going through some physical pain, your body is decaying, you made some bad decisions in your life, and you're going through physical pain. Maybe you have a disorder, maybe a health disorder, mental disorder, where you're actually going through mental pain. It could be a lot of things, but I wanna tell you guys today that pain is good for you. And that is why I, myself, right now, while we're talking about this video, I've been going through something in my life that is a little bit painful for me. But every time I hear that word pain, and it's why you're going through it, in my mind, I'm like, wait, Michael, you need to go through this. This is exactly why you need to go through this, because these are the 7 reasons why you're going to become really successful in your life. When I say success, I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about learning how to deal with yourself, because you got to deal with you till the day you die, and you have to learn how to become successful with yourself. Can you figure out who you are and what you're all about? And that's what we're gonna talk about today. So if you wanna become successful, if you wanna become more in control of who you are and be in control of your actions and your thought process, you need to understand that pain is your best friend, okay? So let's get into the first thing. So the first thing that pain does to you is it creates mental toughness. You see, you cannot become a strong person unless you go through some shit. You have to go through the pain. You have to go through the bullshit. You have to go through the nonsense. You have to go through the mental battle of one day, this little guy over here says, hey, quit. And this guy over here says, hey, you can do it. You have to go through that mental battle. That fight, whatever that happens in the head, right? Think of 2 little people right here fighting with each other every single day. And you have to make a decision. Who are you gonna be cheering for? Are you gonna be cheering for the fucking devil on the side and the one that wants you to lose and quit? Or are you gonna be voting for the guy and cheering for the guy that says, yo, you got this, you can do it. But you have to go through the pain, because that pain is the mental toughness that you build. It's the mental muscle that you build in your head. And when you go through it, you actually become stronger. And I know you guys heard that, no pain, no gain, but it's the freaking truth. You need pain to become stronger. So in the future, when you go through it, you can look back and say, that's nothing, okay? Number 2, there's so many lessons in pain. When you go through pain, for example, why is it that when you touch the hot stove, you literally you touch it and you move your hand right away? Why? Because that pain is teaching you something. God said, here's pain, so you don't make the dumb mistake of touching that stove and leaving your hand on for an hour or two and burning your hand off, okay? So you need pain. Pain's gonna teach you a lot of valuable lessons. A lot of times people go through pain and they get into this pity party and say, why me? Why me? Poor, pitiful me. And that doesn't get you anywhere. Licking your wounds is not gonna succeed. You're not gonna get anywhere by doing that. You have to really look at it and say, okay, what can I learn from this? What is the lessons that I need to learn from? What are the blessings out of this situation? Because the reason why I'm going through this pain is not by accident. God put me through the situation for a reason. He wants me to learn something from this, and I have to learn from it. As a human being, I gotta get better. In order for me to become successful in life, I have to learn me. And in order to learn me, I have to go through the pain and learn what I actually need to do from that situation, okay? The third thing is hard versus challenging, right? So you gotta understand, when you're going through pain, you don't wanna have things hard. Because when things are hard, it's unaccomplishable, right? For example, me picking up this freaking car outside, it's extremely hard and it's probably never gonna happen. But can I actually go to the gym and pick up a 65 pound dumbbell? Yes, I can, but it's a challenge, right? It's challenging. So you don't wanna look at pain as hard, look at it as a challenge. You wanna go through the challenge. Challenge means you can get it done. It just may not be easy. Hard means it's impossible and you can't get it done. So you wanna go through the challenge. You wanna go through those challenges. You want more pain. And like I said, we were talking about another video about problems. You want a lot of problems. Okay, you want a lot of problems, because those problems equal pain, and the pain equals a gain, and that's how you grow, okay? Now, I'm gonna take a little pause on this for a second. If you guys are not subscribed yet to our channel, do me a favor, subscribe right now. You can find us on Instagram, and obviously this is a YouTube channel, but go down, click the little button right here, subscribe, so you can always see these kind of videos, because my whole goal is to impact you guys, so you can have some more pain, and when you have some pain, you watch some of these videos, you learn, and you grow from it, and you go apply, okay? Number 4, pain recognizes pleasure. okay? Pain recognizes pleasure. How the hell do you know what something is actually pleasurable if you don't understand the pain process of it? How do you actually reward yourself and feel amazing about actually having a fit body if you haven't gone through the pain and the struggle and the bullshit that you had to go through for 2 months, 3 months, 3 years, 5 years to end up looking the way you look if you don't understand the pain? You gotta go through the pain in order to appreciate the pleasure. Going through pain is the most biggest blessing on planet Earth. When you really look at it that way, I had one of my friends say today, yo, you look kind of down, let's go get some food. I said, listen, no problem. I have to go through this pain. I have to go through this pain because this pain, when that pleasure comes around the corner, because it will, there's always a valley and there's always a mountain. There will be a pleasure point, 100%. You may not understand that right now because you're in your mud, but when you get out of the mud, there's always a day when you're gonna be clean out of the mud and fresh under the sun. So don't forget that. Pain recognizes pleasure, okay? Number five, pain captures your attention. You see, a lot of times when you're feeling good, you're doing awesome, everything is amazing. You forget to pay attention to some of the stuff. There's no attention. When you have pain, pain says, hey, snap out of it. Pay attention. Something is wrong. When you get a sharp pain under your chest, something is wrong. You've been doing something wrong for many, many years. You gotta fix it. Go to the doctor. Okay, when you get a letter from another company or somebody say, hey, we're gonna sue your ass, that is the problem. You did something wrong, you gotta figure it out. That process of pain says, hey, wake up, pay attention. Look at what you're going through, look at what you're doing. And when you go through pain, it gives you a massive amount of attention to go fix what you need to fix. Because remember, problems are opportunities. When you have that pain, when you have that problem, you go fix it and now you can become successful. Does that make sense? So it captures your attention. Number six, okay? It gets you closer to God. Every time something goes through pain, the first thing to do is please God. And that's what God wants you to do. God wants you to pray to Him. God wants you to talk to Him. And sometimes when things are going so good in your life, you're not really paying attention to God and saying thank you, thank you, thank you. So you gotta understand that God says, hey, here's a little bit of pain. I want you to experience this so you can come closer to me. Beg me to help you. Please pray to me. That's what He's dying for you to do. He's like, my son, my daughter, I love you. I just want you to say thank you and pay attention to me. So here's a little bit of pain so you can come look at me. Because every time you get pain, you pay attention. And you say thank you, and you pray, and you ask for forgiveness, and you ask me to help you. And that's what God wants. So when you're going through pain, understand that God just wants you to pray to Him. Pray to Him to help you. You're my Lord and Savior. You're the best thing that ever happened to me. Please help me, Father. I need your help. I need your assistance to get me through this, okay? You put me here, but you want to help me get through this, okay? Number seven, going through pain helps you relate better with other people. How the hell are you going to relate with other people if you haven't gone through it? You see, me going through foster care, me going through the pain of going through all these 9 schools, me going through pain, all this bullshit, and me becoming successful financially and successful emotionally, learning how to deal with myself. If I could become that beacon of hope for somebody, how can I do that if I have not gone through the bullshit that they've gone through? God says, go through pain, go through the bullshit early on in your life so you can take your hand and say, here, let me help you get up. Because that's the only way you can relate with someone, okay? In order for me to impact you guys, I have to be going through something, I have to go through some bullshit in my life, somehow, some way, for 19, 10, 20 years, whatever it may be, 10 months, it doesn't matter, whatever that problem is or whatever that situation is, to say, here, let me help you solve this situation. So that's what you guys need to understand. Pain is your best friend. So let's go over quickly. Number one, it creates mental toughness, okay? Number two, it gives you lessons on blessings on blessings, okay? Number three, harvest is challenging. Do you want it to be hard or do you want it to be challenging, right? Challenging is actually what you want. Number four, pain recognizes pleasure, okay? Number five, pain actually gives you a chance to kind of capture your attention. You gotta pay attention to the details and sometimes you forget. So pain gives you that. Number six, it gets you closer to God. More pain, more prayers, okay? Number seven, it helps you relate better with other people. Because remember, it's not about you. If it's been about you, then guess what? This world wouldn't be here. It's not about you, it's about us, it's about other people. Once you forget about yourself, you can actually eliminate the pain. Now, we may make another movie on how to actually deal with pain, okay? And what you could do to actually avoid the destruction of pain. Because listen, this is good pain. But sometimes we put ourselves in destructive modes of pain. So we may make a video on that as well. But I love you guys. I want you guys to remember, subscribe down below. Share this with a friend that's going through some pain that they need to actually overcome. Share it with a family member. Share it with a cousin. And hopefully you can go through this pain together with me in a positive way. Have a good one.